This is why people came here in the 50s and 60s. This is why they're coming back, the Indian Ocean. The Carimbas Archipelago, 31 islands covering 580 square miles, a national park and marine reserve. After a 10-hour flight to Johannesburg, a 5-hour flight to Pemba, a 20-minute flight to Carimba, a 15-minute bumpy drive, followed by a 20-minute boat ride.
I've finally arrived at the island resort of Quil Alair, and I must admit, the hustle and bustle and the stresses of travelling and airports, I did have my doubts. But when you see this island for the first time from the boat, you know the journey's been worth it. Now, Quil Alair derives from the Swahili word for sleep or lala, thus this place was known as a place of rest.
It even has its own time zone, an hour later than the mainland, to allow guests to get up late and still get an extra hour of daylight. Both islands in the Quil Alair Resort have been declared the National Park's only sanctuary, which means that on land and in the water, nothing may be collected or damaged. Quil Alair has its own coral reef and takes only 40 minutes to walk around. The resort accommodates just 18 guests in 9 villas.
Well, I've had a good night's sleep, and I have to say, this island's really easy to explore. There aren't any mosquitoes because there isn't any stagnant water, and the only time you see any other guests is at mealtimes.
The owners also have the uninhabited next-door island of Senkar to preserve the island's pristine setting. The interior is a maze of mangroves, and the only way to explore them is by kayak or canoe.
Apart from the bird life, the only other animals here are the elusive Samango monkeys, but they're not unique to the island. They've got a distinctive moustache and dark tail. Now, there's no fresh water here, so for the monkeys to survive, they have to get the rainwater that's collected in the clefts of the mango trees or suck on the young roots and leaves. Unfortunately, I haven't seen any today, but I'm not complaining. It's so peaceful.
Though John Hewlett has these islands, he doesn't want tourism to spoil them, and so is working closely with the government in the development of the Carimbas Archipelago.
My whole intention was to keep things the way they are and make sure they stay the way they are forever. The whole of the East African coast has to some extent been affected by tourism. We had the opportunity here to create something and keep it the way it is. So we created a sanctuary, nothing leaves, not a shell. The fish can breed. We have far more turtles than we ever had. And the fishermen outside the sanctuary are catching bigger fish than they ever caught. The old men say these are fish like they caught when they were boys.
And what are your future developments for the island?
None.
Keep it.
This is how it is.
How it is. It's as near to perfect as it can possibly be.
That's right.
Yeah. The waters around the island are pristine and uncharted. One of the main activities is diving, but you can also snorkel. You can see a wide variety of tropical fish, including banner, damsel and sergeant major.